Hello, in this video I will show you how to use the inundation calculator that I developed at a QGIS plugin, this one. The inundation calculator is designed to provide a simple approximation of the average annual inundation duration in floodplains by using only river water levels and floodplain topography. Flood duration is of great interest because it affects many ecosystem services such as habitat provision, biodiversity, or for example denitrification and other soil biochemical processes for maintaining water quality, and therefore we need to find simple solutions that can be applied by anyone, even if these are only rough approximations. As a user of this plugin, you must be aware of the application limitations. So details of this, as well as download links for the data used, can be found in the report. I will link it below. So now some short words about the functioning of the code. Floodplain inundation is reflected by overland inundation from the river channel to the floodplain when bankfall conditions are exceeded, and flooding from below ground through the filling of the alluvial aquifer. And based on this, raster cells with an elevation below the current river water level are assumed to be inundated in the modeling process. I would like to show it using an example along the Elbe River. So here we go. This is a satellite image of a part of Germany. So, and this is the Elbe River. I have some sampling points over here. Let's zoom to the layer so you can see it better. I would like to know how many days these points, or let's say any point in this area, is flooded on average per year. So first I need a polygon for which I would like to have this information. For German rivers, you can use the floodplain sections which were assessed through the state of support in German floodplains. You can access them using the web feature service provided by the Federal Agency of Nature Conservation. For detailed information, please have a look at the report link below. And here you can see the colored parts show the active floodplain, and the striped area is the former floodplain. So my sampling points are located in three of this active floodplain sections, so I clipped my study area to that size. So next, I need the digital elevation model for my study area as a 64-bit TIFF. This is the digital elevation model of the Elbe floodplain, and again, this can be found online too. And again, I clipped it to the size of my study area, like this. So now I need the daily water level information. I need one value per day and the same unit as the digital elevation model, so meters above sea level. You may get them upon request, and please provide the daily water levels in one column of a CSV file. So let's add this one. Add delimited text. Choose your file with the water level data, open, click on No Geometry, Attribute Only Table, and check the preview to make sure everything is correct, and add. Now the table appears as a CSV file in the layer list, and by opening the attribute table you can check the total features. Make sure that the column length is a multiple of 365. So in my case, I have 10,950 water levels, and 10,950 divided by 365 means 30, so 30 years of water level data. Okay. If the gauging station is not directly located next to the study area, you can make at least one real-time water level difference measurement between the water level at the gauge and the water level in the study area, which for sure is also a very rough approximation, but you can input the difference as a correction factor X. So okay, now we have prepared all of our data. Let's start the plugin. Plugin, floodplain inundation calculator, calculate floodplain inundations. The user interface asks for the topographical height, so the DEM, which was clipped to the size of our study area, and the daily water levels, so water level data, and the correction factor, which in this case is only 5 cm because the gauge is close. And finally, the output file by specifying a path. So I recommend to include the considered GS in a file name, so average inundation days per year, 30 years basis, or something like that, and save. Okay, and that's it. It's very simple, isn't it? And yeah, now we have to wait a little bit, and if everything went well, you will see a congratulation message and a new layer will appear in the layer list. Congratulations. And this is our new layer. The new layer contains values in the range of 0 to 365 or narrower. And yeah, the standard homology is a black to white gradient. But for a nice visualization, I recommend plotting average inundation days per year in quantiles. By this, the entire area is divided into equally sized classes. So right click on properties. Homology, render type, single bin pseudo color, interpolation discrete. Equal in quantile, mode quantile, and choose 5 classes or 6 classes or yeah, whatever you want, and apply. Okay. Now we put it on the top, and there you go, a beautiful layer, easy understandable. So for example, the green parts represent 37 to 55 days of flooding per year, calculated on 30 years basis, and let's check. Okay, and these depressions here are, of course, flooded more often, as you can also see in the aerial picture. So there's water and it's often inundated. Yeah, but this is just an example. There are countless visualization methods. Try yourself. I hope the tutorial was helpful and have fun trying it out.